Hi friends, in this class I am going to explain about the initial conditions of a RLC parameters in case of transient analysis. Clear? So it means if we need to get the transient response of any combination, whether it is a series RL or series RC and series RLC circuits. So if we want the transient analysis or transient response of these particular circuits, so in order to study this concept, first we need to know about the initial conditions of a RLC parameters. Because so in RLC parameters, R is not stores the energy, okay, but where inductor and capacitor, inductor and capacitor always stores the energy in the form of what? Voltage and current. It means what? If you are talking about inductor, it's going to store the energy in the form of current, and about this capacitor, it stores the energy in the form of voltage. Clear? But when compared to inductor and capacitor, R is not stores energy. It means what? Resistor is a dissipating energy. Clear? So that's why, just see here, inductor and capacitor are storing the energy. It means what? Depending upon time, only these inductor and capacitor will store the energy. Yes or no? It means what? For example, the energy stored in the inductor at t is equal to 10 seconds is definitely not equal to the t is equal to 100 seconds. It means what? From 10 seconds to 100 seconds, definitely the amount of energy stored in the capacitor or inductor is definitely changes. That's why we are going to concentrate on the initial conditions of RLC parameters. So why I am going to explaining you in the beginning means, if you know the RLC parameter initial conditions, so then only depending upon the initial conditions of RLC parameters only, we are going to study the transient response of series RL, RC and RLC circuits. Clear? So already we know the properties of RLC parameters. Okay. So what is the main property of resistor? Simply, it opposes the flow of current. Clear? So resistor always opposes the flow of current. So this is the property of resistor. Clear? But what about the properties of inductor and capacitor? So inductor is an element which stores the energy in the form of current, and it does not allow the sudden changes in currents. It means what? For example, at t is equal to 0 seconds, the current flowing in the system is 0 amperes, for example. Then suddenly at t is equal to 1 second, the current will suddenly entering into the or simply flowing in the circuit. So what is the property of your inductor means? Inductor always does not allow the sudden changes in currents. It means what? It will take some time to store the energy. But if the current is directly or suddenly enter into the circuit, or voltage is suddenly entering into the voltage circuit, then the inductor and capacitor does not allow the sudden changes in voltage. So when we are talking about the capacitor, it does not allow the voltage, and if you are talking about the inductor, it does not allow the current. Clear? So that's why at t is equal to 0 seconds, the energy stored in the inductor and capacitor is different, and at t is equal to some 100 seconds, the energy stored in the inductor and capacitor is different. At t is equal to infinity, the energy stored in the inductor and capacitor is also different. It means what? The value or the energy stored in the inductor and capacitor is always changes with respect to time. Clear? So if we know the initial conditions of these three parameters, then it is very simple to understand the concept of transient response of series RL, RC and RLC circuits. Clear? So for that, just see here. So when we are talking about the transient analysis, so definitely in every circuit, whatever it is, circuit number 1, circuit number 2, circuit number 3 or circuit number infinity, whatever it is, but definitely we have to consider one switch in the circuit, because depending upon the operation of this particular switch only, the total operation will depends. Clear? So for example, what I am taking, S is the switch here, and for example here I am taking, this is the voltage source, and this is R, and this one L. For example, this is the RL series circuit. So this one R, this one L, and this is the switch, and here the arrow indicates, if the arrow is downwards and t is equal to 0 seconds, then the switch is going to turn on, or simply the switch is closed at t is equal to 0 seconds. That is the meaning. Now see here, at t is equal to 0 seconds, or at t is equal to 0, switch is closed. It means what about before value? It means what? T is equal to 0 minus condition, what is happening when t is equal to 0 minus condition, and at t is equal to 0, switch is closing. But what is happening when t is equal to 0 plus? Here, why I am going to taking the value 0 minus 0, 0 plus means, so depending upon the switch operation, or the turn on, or the closing of a switch, we are going to consider like this times. It means what? T is equal to 0 minus is one time, t is equal to 0 is another time, and t is equal to 0 plus is another time. Clear? So it means, at t is equal to 0 minus, what is the condition of a circuit? And at t is equal to 0, what is the condition of a circuit? But here clearly he is saying, at t is equal to 0 only, switch is closed. And here t is equal to 0 plus means what? After closing the switch. Yes or no? T is equal to 0 plus condition comes after t is equal to 0. Clear? So like this, in order to study the transient response of series RL, RC, RLC circuit, definitely we have to consider the switch here, because the operation of switch from one state to another state is called as transition. Clear? So that's why, depending upon the switch, or depending upon the operation of switch, closing and opening of a switch only, the total response of a system will depends. So for that, what I am doing here, just see. Just see here. So in order to study about this transient response, so first we are going to get the information of what? Initial conditions of a RLC parameters. Clear? Now just see here. So what I am doing here, for example I am taking element, okay? So here, behavior of element, after t is equal to 0 condition, and here behavior of element at t is equal to infinity condition. It means what? For example, I am taking resistor. Clear? So resistor always denoted with R. Now here, what we are observing from this concept means, so I am going to consider the value, or I am going to consider the resistor in the circuit, and resistor is not stores energy. It is a dissipating element. That's why the behavior of resistance is always same at t is equal to 0 condition, at t is equal to 100 seconds, at t is equal to infinity condition also. That's why resistor always act as a resistor at any time, because this is not going to store the energy. But when we are going to comes to the point of inductor, so inductor always denoted with L. Clear? So here, when we are going to talk about the inductor, now see here, inductor is a storage element which stores the energy in the form of current, and it does not allow the sudden changes in currents. Clear? sudden changes in currents means what? Just see, for example, what I am doing here. This is the switch S. Switch is closing at t is equal to 0 minus condition. For example, there is an inductor like this, and this is the source like this. Clear? Now what is happening? I want the energy stored in the inductor. Okay, I want to calculate the energy stored in the inductor. Now, based on this circuit condition, t is equal to 0, switch is closed. It means t is equal to 0 minus condition. What is the condition of a circuit? Switch is open only, because switch is always closed at t is equal to 0. But this is t is equal to 0 minus before t is equal to 0. That's why t is equal to 0, switch is closed. But at t is equal to 0 minus condition, switch is always open. It means what? Whatever the energy stored in the inductor is always what? Is equal to 0 only. Clear? This is case number 1. Now condition number 2. At t is equal to 0, switch is closed like this. But the time between the 0 minus and 0 is always what? Very, very, very less, like fraction of seconds. It means what? 0 minus to 0, fraction of seconds. It means, what is the property of inductor? It does not allow the sudden changes in currents. Means, the time between the 0 minus and 0 is very, very, very less. That's why, again, at t is equal to 0 also, the energy stored in the inductor is what? Again 0. Clear? So, t is equal to 0 minus over, and t is equal to 0 is also over. Now condition at t is equal to 0 plus. I am talking about 0 plus. 0 plus comes after t is equal to 0. It means at t is equal to 0 plus, already switch is closed at t is equal to 0 only. It means what? This 0 plus comes after t is equal to 0 means, again what? The time between the 0 and 0 plus is also very, very, very less. It means what? Fraction of seconds. That's why, again, the energy stored in the inductor is what? 0 only. It means, based on the property of inductor, it does not allow the sudden changes in currents. That's why t is equal to 0 minus, t is equal to 0, and t is equal to 0 plus also, the energy stored in the inductor is 0. But when it is possible? When it is possible? If inductor having no energy initially. Clear? If the inductor is having no energy in the initially, then same process will repeat in the circuit. So that's why, just see here, up to t is equal to 0 plus also, the energy stored in the inductor, zero means, at t is equal to 0 minus 0 and 0 plus, inductor will act as a, yes, there is no energy in the inductor means, at t is equal to 0, what is the condition of a inductor here? Yes, current 0, it means what? T is equal to 0 minus, t is equal to 0, and t is equal to 0 plus. The energy stored in the inductor is 0. It means what? Current 0. When it is possible, current 0. Current 0 means, always current 0 in short circuit or open circuit? Definitely in short circuit only. It means what? When we are talking about short circuit, yes, if it is a short circuit, the current value is always is equal to maximum. Clear? In short circuit, current is always max. And here, voltage is equal to 0. Clear? But here, inductor, t is equal to 0 minus, t is equal to 0, and t is equal to 0 plus condition, current in the inductor is 0. That's why current is always not equal to, current is equal to 0 in t is equal to 0 minus, t is equal to 0, and t is equal to 0 plus means, definitely the value of current is equal to 0 in open circuit paths. Open circuit means what? Like this. Clear? So just see here. If it is an open circuit like this, this is the open circuit, then in this cases only the value of current is 0. Clear? It means 0 minus 0 and 0 plus. In all these conditions, current value 0. But when current is 0? When the circuit is open circuited like this. That's why at t is equal to 0 minus condition, inductor will act as a open circuit. Clear? Just to see here. So that's why when we are solving the problems, or when we are going to discuss about the transient response of series RC and RLC circuits, so at t is equal to 0 condition, inductor will act as a open circuit like this. Clear? Yes, this is happened. Yes, when it is possible at t is equal to 0 minus 0 and 0 plus. Clear? So that's why behavior of circuit behavior of element after t is equal to 0 is open circuit. But when t is equal to infinity condition, t is equal to infinity means what? The time between the 0 plus and infinity is very, very, very high. It means what? The time required for the inductor is very high. That's why definitely at t is equal to 0 minus condition, definitely there is a possibility of energy stored in the inductor. That's why inductor will act as a short circuit like this. Clear? So when t is equal to 0 condition, inductor will act as a open circuit, and when t is equal to infinity condition, definitely there is a energy stored in the inductor, because we are talking about t is equal to infinity condition. That's why it will act as a short circuit. Now these two are possible when inductor having no energy initially. Clear? If for example inductor having some energy initially. So here I naught represents inductor having some energy initially. Clear? So in this condition, already we have energy stored in the inductor, and this element we are connecting in the circuits. In the circuits means what? Already the energy stored in the inductor, already there is some value of energy available in the inductor. It means at t is equal to 0 minus 0 and 0 plus, definitely this inductor will not act as an open circuit, already having some energy. That's why inductor will act as a current source. Clear? Inductor will act as a current source. So this is happened when t is equal to 0 minus 0 and 0 plus. Not 0 minus, because 0 minus condition always switches open only, but condition of our energy stored in the inductor is always same in all conditions. 0 minus 0 and 0 plus. That's why I'm telling you. Clear? So this is happened after t is equal to 0. Now this inductor, how the behavior of inductor at t is equal to infinity? It means already the inductor will act as a short circuit when the inductor having no energy. That's why same it will act as a short circuit like this. This is short circuit, but already inductor having some energy I naught, and it will act as a current source. That's why when the inductor having some energy initially I naught, if it is connecting in the system, it will act as a current source at t is equal to 0, and here it will act as a current source connected across short circuited path like this. Clear? So this is the behavior of an inductor when an inductor having some energy. Clear? Now go for the last one, capacitor. Capacitor C. Clear? Now just see here, capacitor is an element which stores energy in the form of voltage, and it does not allow the sudden changes in voltages. Same condition, 0 minus condition, what is the energy stored in the capacitor? Again at t is equal to 0, what is the energy stored in the capacitor? Again at t is equal to 0 plus, what is the stored in the capacitor? It means what? 0 minus 0 and 0 plus. Same, the energy stored in the capacitor, always what? V naught is equal to 0 volts only. Because of the property of inductor, it does not allow the sudden changes in voltages. That's why the energy stored in the capacitor is 0. When it is possible, when the value of voltage is 0, in which condition? Whether it is in short circuit or whether it is in open circuit, always the value of E naught is equal to 0 in short circuited path. always short circuited path V naught is equal to 0 only. Clear? It means capacitor will act as a short circuit after t is equal to 0. But this capacitor will act as a open circuit when t is equal to infinity condition. Because in short circuited path, current max V naught 0. But in open circuit path, current 0, voltage not equal to 0. That's why at t is equal to infinity condition, capacitor will act as a open circuit. That's why V naught not equal to 0 volts. Clear? So this is the behavior of capacitor. If capacitor having no energy, for example, if capacitor having some energy V naught like this. Now, yes, see here. If capacitor already having some energy V naught initially, and this element we are connecting in the system like this. Now, what we are going to do? We are running the system, and the behavior of capacitor after t is equal to 0. Yes, already having some energy. It means what? It will act as a what? Voltage source. It will act as a voltage source initially, because already this capacitor having some energy stored. So already having some energy, that's why at t is equal to 0 only, it will act as a voltage source. But if the system is running and we are going to check the behavior of capacitor at t is equal to infinity, it means what? So already having some energy, and already we know that capacitor will act as a open circuit at t is equal to infinity condition if capacitor having no energy. That's why capacitor here this is V naught, this plus minus. So already same condition I am drawing here, and already having some voltage initially. That's why this voltage source is connecting like this. So V naught, this is plus and minus. Clear? So like this, the initial conditions of a RLC parameters in the transient analysis like this. Okay, if we know the initial conditions of all these three parameters clearly, then it is very, very, very simple to understand the concepts of what? Transient analysis of RL, RC and RLC circuits. Clear? So this is the initial condition of RLC parameter. So in the next class, I'm going to explain about the transient response of series RL and transient response of series RC and transient response of series RLC circuits with derivations. Clear? So please follow my channel, and if you like the videos, if you are getting a very clear explanation from my side, then please do subscribe my channel and share with your friends. Clear? Thank you so much, guys.